So one of the very interesting things that I've read is by this gentleman, Jean Vanier. Jean Vanier actually passed away about a year ago, a ripe old age of 90. He was the founder of an organization called LARC International. Now, he has some fantastic books. If you Google him, you will see that, okay? And he talks about, you know, various, he's actually, there's a treasure trove of ideas, of reflections on how to lead a good life. And there is this book, Tears of Silence, by Jean Vanier. You know, there he says, and I'm going to read this out. He says, he who clutches desperately to the security of everyday habits, that is your work, organization, friends, family, no longer lives. More than security, life needs adventure, risk, dynamic activity, self-giving, and presence to others. Now, combining this with Traigunya Vishaya Veda Nistraigunyo Bhavarjuna Nirdvandvo Nitya Satvasto Niryoga Kshema Matmava. Combining this with that, what do we see? If we have to live a life of adventure, if we have to live a life of dynamic activity, in whichever environment we are in, with our family, with our friends, within our organization, you know, in the work that we do, if we have to do that, one needs to give up that clutching, that selfish, desire-ridden existence. Nirdvandvo, Ditya Satvasto, Niryoga Kshema. We need to give it up. If we give it up, this happens. But on the contrary, what do we see around all of us? Human beings have desperately clung on, okay, to the extremities. They have clung on to them in the many-branched way, without being firm, flitting from one thought, one idea, one desire to the other. And they have clung on to it by protecting what they have, desiring what they do not have. That is what we see all around us. And as a result, you know, this life of dynamic, people who live life dynamically, people who live life in the manner that we just saw, they've almost become misfits in society. Because the other society has become so common that the dynamic existence has become a misfit. If I suddenly say that I'm going to go spend the next 6 months in the Himalayas, everybody will like, hey, what are you doing? Don't go. I'll become a misfit, you know. But that would be a dynamic existence. You know, even 2 weeks there is unbelievably reinvigorating. So there was this kingdom, okay, which had two wells. One of the wells was for the Raja, the king, the ministers and the families of the king and the ministers. The other well was for everybody else, all the citizens, the subjects of the kingdom. One day there was a magician who got very angry with the people in the kingdom and he poisoned one of the wells, okay, which is the well of the people that got poisoned. So poison means what? Not the poison which kills you. This poison made people who ever drank water from the well mad. So if you drink water from the well, you become mad. So people used to drink, whoever drank became mad. And the others saw this and said, hey, what's going on? So you stop drinking. But that's the only well. There's no other potable water in the kingdom. If you don't drink, what will happen over a period of time? You'll fall sick, you can die, and so on and so forth. So people started dying. So the choice was either you drink and become mad, or you don't drink and die. So then slowly and surely people drink because you can't exist without drinking water. So over a period of time, the entire kingdom became mad. Now, all the people, the citizens of the kingdom were mad. And the king, the ministers and the families were sane. But the beauty of madness is that the people who are mad think that they are sane. And the people who are sane are the ones who are actually mad. So the entire kingdom thought, we are sane people. These rulers are mad. What happened to them? They are crazy. Why are we allowing them to rule over us? You know, let's get rid of them. Now this stupefied the king, the ministers and their family. What do I do? Okay, now I'll be thrown out or I'll be killed. You know, I don't have a choice. So they conferred among themselves. And finally, the idea was either you have to leave the kingdom and run away. But running away outside, what will happen? No other kingdom is going to welcome them. This is their kingdom. They want to be kings. So the only option it was decided was, let's also drink the water from the well. So the king and the ministers and the families drank the water from that poisoned well, and all of them also became mad. And this entire kingdom of mad people, I'm sorry, the entire kingdom of sane people ruled and lived happily ever after. Okay, so this is our world. The selfish have prospered and the selfless have become selfish.